Bring flowers of the fairest, bring flowers of the rarest, from garden and woodland and hillside and vale. Our full hearts are swelling, our glad voices telling the praise of the loveliest rose of the vale. O Mary, we crown thee with blossoms today, Queen of the angels, Queen of the May. O Mary, we crown thee with blossoms today, Queen of the angels, Queen of the May.
Hello. My name is Maria Luisa Ugarte, a proud alumni of Our Lady of Lourdes in Chicago, Illinois. I graduated in 1969. The following documentary is a compilation of memories over the decades from the 1930s to the 1970s. I wish we had more, but I hope that this will remind you of some of those very special memories while we were growing up in the Our Lady of Lourdes community. This represents things that really matter to us: our education, our values, and the love of our family and friends. I hope you will enjoy this. Our Lady of Lourdes School was open from 1892 until 2004. The building is located in the Ravenswood community area in Chicago at Ashland and Leland. The school was founded by the Sisters of Charity of the Blessed Virgin Mary, who lived in this convent across from the school. Today, the building houses the Northwestern Institute of Health and Technology. This is how the building looks in 2019. The front door was actually our exit door every day. All students were taught the virtues of wisdom, understanding, counsel, fortitude, knowledge, piety, and fear of the Lord. There were three floors of 10 or 12 classrooms. There were daily announcements on our PA system by our principal, Sister Verilyn, in the 1960s. This was part of the kindergarten class. Most of us remember the roller coaster. The basement was our cafeteria and the food was great. We all remember Yo-Ho potato chips. At the end of every school day, we marched out in two lines to Philip Sousa marches. Thousands of students exited through these doors. Our Lady of Lourdes Church is famous for being moved across Ashland in 1929 to widen the street. It weighed 10,000 tons and moved a foot per minute. The church celebrated its first Mass in 1892. The church is Spanish Renaissance style, with elaborate art on the ceilings, chandeliers, marble pillars, and stained glass windows. Many Lourdes children and families have received all of their blessed sacraments here. The grotto is a replica of the original grotto in Lourdes, France.
So one of the things that we really emphasize at Our Lady of Lourdes is the fact that diversity does not separate us, language does not separate us, way of life does not separate us, but the Christ that we celebrate can unite us. And so it stands really as a symbol of what we hope for in our culture, in our country. And so we go to great lengths when we're having a parish event. It doesn't have just music from one country. It must have music from American culture, from Filipino culture, from all of the Latino countries. It must have food, you know, coming from all different countries. It must have languages being spoken. Several times a year, we have masses that are either bilingual or trilingual. We just do this naturally. We recognize that that's not always comfortable, you know, for us, especially in the assembly. You may not know what's going on. So we do the best we can to make it a ministry and a liturgy that's hospitable.
In 2017, the church celebrated its 125th anniversary. Alumni from the 30s to the 70s share some of their memories of Our Lady of Lourdes School.
Maureen Roach Kennedy and Sister Josephine Roach, BVM, these lovely twins graduated in the class of 1938.
Okay. And my love for basketball all through high school and college, I think it began here because we started to have a little bit of basketball toward the end of our career as grade school children.
And she was in an all-star team in high school and an all-star team in college.
Where was high school, ladies?
Immaculata and Mundelein College. BVMs all the way through. Grade school.
I just remember having happy days here. I remember Monsignor Campbell was our pastor, and when we were in eighth grade, he treated the whole class to a movie. And the movie was one of the children's, oh no, I'm trying to think what it is, one of the children's movies that's so popular.
Like Pinocchio or a cartoon kind? Cinderella?
Was it Cinderella?
Snow White?
I miss it now, but I remember being so impressed by that because I don't think we went to movies that often. And it was just a real treat. And we had such wonderful teachers. I can remember every name of my teacher all the way through from first to eighth grade.
Did you have a favorite teacher?
Yes, I think I did. Sister Bernadette, Sister Mary Bernadette. Sister Mary St. Edgar was another one that was awfully good in fourth grade.
And Sister Mary Orestes, our eighth grade teacher,
was marvelous.
We learned so much. We were able to enter those contests for scholarships because she prepared us. And we both got scholarships to high school.
So you have a lot to be grateful for,
yes,
Our Lady
very
of
much,
Lourdes.
Very much.
Yeah. Did you both go K to 8 here the whole time?
No K. There was no K here.
Oh, there was no kindergarten at the time?
No.
Wait, they cheated.
Okay.
Tell the story, Mom. How did you cheat?
Yeah, well, we were in the public school for kindergarten. And I guess my mother thought we were ready for first grade. She came over here in the middle of the year, and she got us enrolled, and they took us. And Sister Janita, our wonderful first grade teacher, she got us caught up with the class reading and everything else.
Yeah.
And so we could make our first communion a month early because our birthday wasn't until June. So the pastor had to question us and see if we really were ready. So I guess we passed because we did make our first communion.
Now, did they have May crownings? When I was here, there were May crownings.
Oh, yes. Wonderful. Beautiful, beautiful.
And they had one of the students was dressed up in white and crowned the Virgin.
Yes.
And there were songs
so
and
beautiful.
Hymns.
Those are wonderful memories. I regret that young people today haven't had that experience, you know, with also my Catholic schools having to close. I think they are being somehow denied wonderful experiences.
And did you eat lunch in school every day?
No, we went home for lunch.
Yeah.
Yeah, my mother.
So you had enough time to go home.
Enough time, yes. The parish, you know,
they didn't have a cafeteria at that time. See.
And also, Catholic schools, usually children went to their homes because would they be close enough?
And how far did you live from school?
Oh, about
just four, maybe four blocks.
Three to four.
So you walked four blocks every day and four blocks back.
Something like that.
Yeah.
It varied.
One of our neighbors asked my mother once, do they ever walk? Because we ran all the time.
What street did you live on?
We lived actually on Palina. And Hermitage.
Okay.
Different times.
Okay. Well, I really appreciate your time. This is so memorable. Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Have a wonderful rest
of the day. So that everyone knows, this is Mary Fran Kennedy Nisnik, named after the foundress of the BVM order, Mother Mary Frances Clark.
Yes.
Right.
So she means a lot to us.
Right.
Also, an Our Lady of Lourdes graduate, 1974, and Immaculata graduate, 1978. And these two lovely ladies, I was lucky enough to even have her teach me at the Immaculata. So yes, we're BVM all the way. And I had 8 siblings, and we all attended school here. And lovely May crownings, and lots of traditions, and a lot of historical memories here, because they've lived here, well, she's lived here 91 years. So it's the marriages were here, and the baptisms were here, and, you know, it's been a long time. So we really love this parish. It's really in our heart.
It's kind of a home away from home.
That's right. We all come back to it. So we hope it lives another 125 more. Of course, we won't be here, but we hope it will.
I think we'll all be watching from heaven, right? Yeah. Thank you, ladies.
I'm JoAnne Festle. I am relatively on the outskirts of Lourdes. I've only been in the parish about 60 years. Did not go to Lourdes. I'm probably the only one on this video that did not. But I married into a family that was here in the early 1900s, believe it or not. I'm the only family around, I think, that has 4 generations. So my husband was one of 4 kids that went to Lourdes. His mother did. Our 5 kids did. And so because of that is the way I met so many of the kids, because I would come to playground duty or cafeteria duty, sometimes with a stroller in hand. Became active with the Mother's Club and the school board. And then got to meet a lot of people through the carnival and all kinds of activities that we seem to get involved in. So I met a lot of really nice kids and really nice parents. My connection to Lourdes is kind of on the outskirts. Taught at Immaculata for the good BVMs, and I know you're going to get a good education. Whether you like it or not, you did. Love Lourdes. Worked at the rectory for 20 years after my 26th at Lourdes school. So we'll go back a long time. That's why I think I know so many of the people, and I love it. So I'm so glad Maria's doing this to make a little history for a wonderful place. And that's it.
I'm Patricia Todd, the class of 1959. I went here from 1951 through 1959. It was a wonderful experience. My favorite memory is of 8th grade with Sister Mary Irene Patricia, and I was on the debating team, and she was a very young nun, and she was cool, so we all just loved her. Anyway, I remember her getting us ready for the May crowning, for the 8th grade dance, and it was really a great time, really a great time. I remember every one of the nuns' names from kindergarten all through 8th grade. They were all unique and special in their own way. Some were nicer than others. Sister Mary Aquinas of 7th grade comes to mind as one of the stricter ones. I remember being in the office a lot, and I remember walking to school every day, and I used to go home for lunch because we lived close enough, and it's good to be back in school and see everything that is still here that I remember. And I remember walking out every day to the Washington Post March. Very fond memories. It was a very safe, I felt very safe when I was attending school here. That was, when I look back, I just felt safe. The nuns and the priests made you feel safe, which is a good thing for a child. Very good thing. Thank you.
I am Bernie Walsh, class of 1961. And my favorite memory of Lourdes is after I graduated, long time, 1992, here at Lourdes Church, we started Perpetual Adoration. We've been going for 25 years, and best thing about it, all the Filipinos, whites, and Hispanics worked together to make this thing go, and it was true teamwork. And so that's really what we should be all about, and that's it. Thank you.
I am Carmen Ugarte, now Peak from 67. One of my favorite memories have to do with what happened after we all went to First Friday's mess. We actually ended up going over to the cafeteria for milk and donuts, and my favorite was chocolate milk with a chocolate donut. That's it.
I remember Mary Joyce sitting across the aisle from me, and I would make her laugh. It was so easy, and it was so much fun. It was great.
And I know I turned as red as a beet and laughed till I laughed out loud.
One of the memories I have of Our Lady of Lourdes School is that when I was in fourth grade, a closed-circuit TV studio was brought in, and there would be a television in every room. The first year, they instituted a talent show. Two of my friends and I danced La Cumbia, which is a Latin dance. I was so nervous. I was so scared. And I remember thinking, the whole school is watching.
Smile.
One of my fondest memories of Our Lady of Lourdes was May crowning. And we would go and pick bouquets of flowers. To this day, lilies of the valley are my favorite.
I'm here, class of 71. Favorite memory would have to be going back and forth to Chase Park for recreation. All the sports we played, the softball games across the street in the park, coming back and being all dirty, and the nuns getting mad at us for wrestling up our uniforms. I even tried to find a blue tie in my little shirt, couldn't do it. But thanks everybody for coming. Hope everybody had a great time. And we'll hope to see you again soon. Thanks.
Hi, it's Paul Capello coming to you from Our Lady of Lourdes 2018, July 5th. I attended Our Lady of Lourdes from 1963 to 1972, kindergarten through the 8th grade. Had a very good teaching experience with the PVN nuns and the priests. Some of you may remember some of those names. Sister Melissa, Sister Teresa Rosa, Father Slex, Father Goldrick. I was an altar boy, I was a choir boy, played all kinds of sports across the street at Chase Park. A lot of the people I grew up with, I still keep in touch with. My parents and I lived on Paulina and Lawrence, walking from the school. I remember those cold, cold mornings in the winter, having to go serve the 6:15 Mass. Anyway, Our Lady of Lourdes holds a very dear memory to me, my family. I just purchased one of those bricks last year over there by the grotto. Still a very special place in my heart for Our Lady of Lourdes. We'll always have those memories. A lot of the people that I keep in touch with are still around Chicagoland. I've lived in different parts of the country. I'm down in Florida now, but I'm doing this because of the memories that Our Lady of Lourdes, the whole experience I had from 63 to 72, was very, very, very positive.
So my name is Judy Flores Remington, and I started kindergarten here at Our Lady of Lourdes. My very first memory and lovely memory was performing for the kindergarten class in Spanish to a classroom of kids who only spoke English, and it was quite daunting, but I did it. It was, yo tengo una muñeca vestida de azul, zapatitos blancos, delantal de tul. Una mañanita le saqué a pasear, le metí a la cama con mucho dolor. Dos por dos son cuatro, cuatro y dos son seis, seis y dos son ocho y ocho, dieciséis. It was so hard for me to do it, but I did it, and I had a little doll. It was dressed in a blue dress with white shoes, and I had a wonderful time doing it after the fact. During the time, it was very difficult, but I went through it, and that is one of my favorite memories. And I graduated in 1974. Thanks.
Big families, you know, like the Kennedy families and Travis. If you say a last name and then they all know somebody in there.
Well,
class.
And Anita's mother, Lupkers.
Nothing.
Lupkers, Annette grew up here too.
Yeah.
So she was raised on Hermitage, 46 Center Block, where that weird place is now.
No, not by you, but my sister
lived here. My parents still live there. I'm serving in Asheville.
3700 Block.
And
the 37. Yeah.
And
the 3700 Block.
So far,
yeah. Killed there.
So unfortunately,
over the
as far as
summer,
1988, OLL, Javier Burgos.
Very nice.
088.
Yeah.
I'm Claudia Spadia, class of 1987. My most favorite memory is being in eighth grade in Ms. Dalton's classroom and having those special treats of World's Finest Chocolates on a Friday after our history class. So thanks, Ms. Dalton, for the whole fine chocolates, and glad to be here for our celebration.
Hi, my name is Oliver Rotana, class of 86, here at Our Lady of Lourdes, and I want to talk about the yellow line that used to be outside in the parking lot where the girls and the boys would be on separate sides. Those are just one of my crazy memories that I have. And Our Lady of Lourdes basketball, although I was in it for a short time, Our Lady of Lourdes, it rocks, it's cool, I'm glad to be here, thank you.
One of my fondest memories of Our Lady of Lourdes, I came here as a child from Peru. I am an immigrant, and proudly so. The Sisters of Charity of the Blessed Virgin Mary, beginning with Sister Maria Melissa, our music teacher, followed by, of course, Sister Josephine Roach, who was the musician for the Spanish Mass at that time at the church, and all the other sisters that were instrumental in our education and who really helped for me and make me the musician that I am today. I remember all the sisters fondly. Sister Aquino, Sister Aquinas, Sister Carol Marie, you name them all. Sister Johanna, Sister Lolita, Sister Emmeline, all the greats. Sister Edgar at the time, and I know she changed her name, Sister Catherine McNulty. But all the sisters were instrumental. I love them all, and I'm very grateful for them. God bless you. Love you.
Okay, well, one of the reasons I loved Lourdes was the nuns. The BVMs were famous, wonderful teachers. I had come in contact with them when I taught at Immaculata, another BVM school. And Mary, weren't we saying that the school revolved around the nuns, the wonderful nuns? They were tough, wonderful teachers, discipline, which you don't always find. But equally committed were those wonderful lay teachers. I mean, the girls and boys that went through Lourdes were really lucky, because it doesn't happen every place. Wouldn't you agree?
I would agree with that.
Yeah. Big classes of 50 in a class in some cases, just marvelous. So we got to give them credit, mostly up in heaven. That's it.
That's a great question. What do we remember or think about with Our Lady of Lourdes? And there's a lot. There's a lot to say about Our Lady of Lourdes Parish. But as pastor, something that comes to mind for me quite often is we're oftentimes talking about how our culture is experiencing, you know, great difficulties, a lot of cynicism, a lot of lack of faith, maybe people don't seem to be too kind with one another, all kinds of things like that. I sort of pay attention to that as a priest. And what goes on, though, at Our Lady of Lourdes Parish is the exact opposite. It's just a bold statement, countercultural statement of what people can do when they come together. We have 32 different groups in the parish. Chicagoland, we're considered a medium-sized parish, but these 32 groups just volunteer in an amazing way every day. There is something happening here at Our Lady of Lourdes Parish. And people with a great sense of dedication and commitment and spirit and faith and goodness and light and kindness and love. And our team of volunteers are doing all kinds of things. For instance, visiting the sick, taking care of the people in the hospitals, doing all the liturgical ministries. We have 4 choirs. We have a number of devotional groups who come from their individual countries and maintain their devotions from Guatemala or from Colombia or from Mexico in the Philippines, just embracing these traditions that are very, very important for these folks that have come from other countries to maintain that sense of identity, but also to share that tradition and that devotion, that fervent faith with people here, with American culture. We have groups that work with young people. We have groups that work with children. We have groups that work with married couples. We have a 24-hour perpetual adoration chapel that is practically unknown anymore these days in Catholic parishes. I don't know, maybe there's two or three in the Archdiocese of Chicago. It's open 24 hours a day, every day of the year to people. We have a soup kitchen. I do recognize that I'm the pastor and extremely biased, and I'd be the first one to admit that, and I brag about Our Lady of Lourdes Parish. We have a soup kitchen that has been in existence since about, I think, 1985, feeding 100 to 150 people every single week, and not just soup. I'm talking about a full meal. Since 1985, every Wednesday in our parish, supported by our own volunteers, our contributions, and generosity of parishioners, feeding hundreds of thousands of people over these years. Commendable.
Across the street from the school was Chase Park. The original field house was torn down, and this is now a modern building. As children, we enjoyed many activities here, such as swings, slides, monkey bars, sports, parties, plays, tennis, and ice skating. We sure loved the sprinkler on those hot summer days, and we made rainbows from drinking fountains. The pool was added in the late 60s. After we graduated from 8th grade, many of us stayed connected through Chase, especially since we attended different high schools. Our crowd grew bigger when kids from other high schools joined us. There were Chase Park girls and Chase Park boys. Most of us honored curfew, and our parents knew where we were. Those were the good old days.
really hope you enjoyed this as much as I did. These were wonderful times. So many rich memories. So many beautiful friendships were formed.
They last a lifetime. The friendships,
the memories, our faith, our virtues, and this incredible foundation that was given to us by our families, by our nuns. These will be treasured
for a lifetime. Thank you for watching.